Late Night Health continues in about 15 minutes. Robert Williams will be joining us. His book is Love is the Power, One Man's Journey to Heal the Heart of Humanity. That'll be happening in about 15 minutes from now. Our guest is Vanessa Rissetto, and she's coming to California. She's going to cook for Daryl and me. Maybe Ron can come. We may have
totally.
And we're going to have the Feast of Seven Fishes.
Sounds good. Can't wait.
You can't wait. I can't
my favorite time of year.
Yeah, mine too. And I don't celebrate. We're talking about food. Let's talk about that. The Feast of Seven Fishes is a celebration before Christmas. It's an Italian tradition, and it's usually fresh fish of all kinds, seafood and fish. It would appear to me to be quite healthy.
It depends on your family and what your family wants to make. So we do a cioppino, so an Italian like seafood stew, and we do, you know, tomato base with a chicken broth, so it's not cream, it's a thin broth. We do like mussels, and we'll put cod in there, and you know, some shrimp. We do a lot of grilled fish. We do branzino.
Oh boy.
We do clams. My husband really likes like clams and linguine. And then we also make a ravioli from scratch, and that actually doesn't have any fish in it at all. There's like a sausage base with ricotta and lots of desserts. So it just depends on what your family is into. But my husband's family doesn't do a lot of fried things. We do
which
like
is
all
great,
grilled.
Which is good. When I was at the fish market yesterday, I actually saw branzino, which is a favorite firm white fish. Firm flesh, and it's really good, but I just noticed it's now being farm-raised. I know.
Yeah. you know, it's really interesting. I had an aunt, and she was like, the best fish is this farm-raised fish. And I'm like, actually, they feed those fish chicken feathers and, you know, oil, like car oil. And she was like, that's not true. Like, it is.
Ooh.
And so she was really shocked and taken aback. And now she's like, I can't eat any fish because everything that's wild caught is so expensive. And ever since you told me how they feed these fish, I won't eat it. So now I'm in trouble. I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry, Aunt Grace. I'll buy you some fish.
And right, and there are some farm-raised fish. The fishmonger told me, that's an old term, by the way, fishmonger told me that the farm-raised fish that Whole Foods carries is different than regular farm-raised fish, like the tilapia that people are... I can't even eat it anymore.
Yeah, well, tilapia is
tilapia.
Raised... Yeah, tilapia is raised to eat the waste of souls. So that's like another reason... That's another thing, another reason like not to eat those kinds of fishes. Even though I know people really like them and they're quote-unquote this white, light fish, they're not necessarily good because whatever, you know, they're eating waste and then we're eating them, and so that can't really be good for us at all.
No, not at all. And what gets me is that there are ways of raising fish, like the branzino that Whole Foods is bringing in. They tell me that it's no antibiotics, no nothing, and they're being fed natural foods. And the same thing with their farm-raised salmon. I did not buy the farm-raised salmon because the coho not only was the same price, but it just looked better to me.
I mean,
it was so good.
Yeah, if that is true and they're raising their fish in a better environment, like giving them, you know, room to swim and feeding them properly, then yeah, that's great, and that would be amazing. And as you said, it's the same price, right? And so that's still going to deter people. They're not going to want to spend that much money. So
right, yeah, and it was, you know, dinner last night for two was around $14.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Which that's a lot. That's expensive.
It's a lot for some families. You know,
got
like
it.
I live in Hoboken, you're in L.A., like, we are used to something different, but when we think about the majority of people, $14, that might be all they have at the end of the week after they pay all their bills. So they couldn't possibly eat this beautiful piece of fish because what if something were to happen and they needed that money?
And it's sad. Right. We had organic broccoli, and I made a mistake of buying organic Brussels sprouts, but that will be on the menu tomorrow night. Anyway, in our remaining couple of minutes, what would you suggest is the number one thing American families can do to be healthy in what they eat?
I think that Americans really need to educate themselves. Really spend a little bit of time, whatever it is. Is it the New York Times food section, the science section? Just try to read one article that is really evidence-based about food. And that will sort of get them thinking in a different mindset. And also, let's try to go back to why can't our kids have fruit as a sweet treat instead of a cookie?
Not saying
that they can't have, they can have cookies. Sure, my kids eat cookies. But why does the cookie always have to be the go-to?
That's
why
true.
Why don't we keep...
Vanessa, we're out of time. I can't believe how fast. We'll have to have you come back, okay?
Yes, please. Yes.
Okay,
you
got it. Vanessa Rissetto, the registered dietitian and nutritionist to the stars, Facebook.com. Vanessa, Rissettord, to find out more. Vanessa, talk to you very soon.
Thanks so much, guys. Have a great day.
Thank you. You too. All right. Coming up next, we're going to talk with Robert Williams. And the Love is the Power. Don't go away. More coming up.